The div element is one of the first things a lot of us learn in HTML. So early on, many of us learned to rely on the div element religiously to build the layouts of our web projects. Although web pages will still render with this approach, HTML5 offers a handful of semantic elements that help the browser understand the meaning of the content instead of just displaying it, hence the name semantic. Not only is this easier for you and other developers to read the code, but providing the extra level of clarity, it also helps search engines read the page and find the required information faster. In this video, I'm going to review 9 semantic HTML elements you can start using today to replace divs and improve your markup. First on the list is the main element, which represents the main content of a document. Content in this element should be unique to the document and not repeated in documents like sidebars, headers, navigation, footers, and forms. If the content represents a major navigation component in your project, you should consider using the nav element. Between the nav, you should also be sure to use link tags. The article element can stand alone from the rest of the content and be distributed independently from the rest of the site. News stories, blog posts, forum posts, and comments are all great examples of content that should be wrapped in an article element. The header element is used to define a header section for the element that contains it. You'll typically see it used as a header to a page, but it can also be used as a header for an article or any other piece of on-page content. The section element defines an important section of a document and usually groups common elements by theme. You can use sections within articles, headers, footers, or to define navigation. The figure element identifies self-contained content related to the main content, such as an image, table, or chart. You'll often find the fig caption element nested within the figure in order to add a caption to the content as well. The aside element represents a portion of a document whose content is only indirectly related to the document's main content. You'll often find author information, related links, related content, and advertisements in aside elements. The block quote element defines a block of text that is a direct quotation. Don't confuse the block quote element with the quote element, though. The quote element should be used when the quote is in line with surrounding text, and the block quote should be used when the quote is its own paragraph. Last is the footer element. This defines a footer for a document or section and should contain information about the containing element, including authorship information, copyright information, sitemap, and related documents. With these 9 semantic elements defined, let's quickly structure a basic HTML page using them. First, we'll create a header element inside our body that will wrap our site's main navigation. In the nav, we'll add a few links to important pages. Below the closing header element, we'll create a main element, which will represent our page's main content. Then we'll add an article element that will hold all the product listings. The article element will have its own header, which will explain what the content is about. When the header is added, we'll create the first section, which will hold our first product type. This section will have its own header with a heading and text as well. We'll also add a figure element, which will have an image and fig caption. With this section completed, we'll create a similar one, changing the title and figure elements. The next section will hold a series of customer quotes, so we'll add 3 block quote elements and put the text for each quote between. We can also use a footer element for representing the name of each person from the quote. The last element we'll add in the article is an aside element that will hold a navigation for related product types. We'll also add a header here with a heading that explains the aside's content. Now, outside the closing article and main element, we'll add a footer for the page. Within the footer, we'll add a nav with links to important pages. And there we go. We've used all 9 semantic HTML elements to structure our page without relying solely on divs. And if you still need help deciding which semantic element to use, check out this handy flowchart in the description below. Also, please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you found it helpful. I'm Hunter from SkillThrive, and I'll see you in the next video.